the dance competition? Yeah. Yeah. You know, I got here well over an hour early to start preparing, and some of you were already waiting. So I appreciate that. I appreciate that. I hope you guys ended up with good seats that were waiting. Oh, man. This is going to be a really, really, really awesome dance comp. We had a bunch of people sign up for prelims well in advance of the convention, and now we've got the 20-some-odd best coming up here to dance for you. And we even have a special treat this year. We actually had so many groups sign up and get through to the finals that we're gonna have a separate group category, so that's very exciting, very exciting. So if you guys don't know, my name's Dushep, I'm from the Boston area. My name's Dushep, I'm from the Boston area. Friends with Gail, she drank too much, so I'm here. Yeah, it's weird, I don't know how that happens. We're never really in the same place at the same time. You know, I'm either too drunk or she's too drunk. It's weird. Weird how that happens. Don't be like me, kids. Don't do it. It's not a good life. Not a good look. So, okay. I got to do a little experiment. We did this yesterday with Floor Wars. It worked really well. When you guys give your energy, the dancers are going to give you more energy. So, I'm going to stand right here. In the middle of the room, we're gonna do a quick test. I'm gonna do this side of the room, then that side of the room, all right? We're gonna be testing your volume level. All right, everybody, prepare yourselves. How excited are you this side of the room? Okay. And how excited are you this side of the room? I hate to say it, I think that side's got it. Yeah. You guys are just gonna, you know, get that coffee to set in, wake up, because we need that energy. But we also got something very critical to dance comps here, and that is our beautiful judges. So I would like our judges to introduce themselves, tell us who you are, and then we're gonna get started with your first dancer, who's gonna send you for a doozy. So judges, who are you? Is it on? No, did you make the switch on? What color are they? Green and blue. Keep talking into them and maybe they'll turn on someday. That requires me to walk down dangerous, precarious situations. Yes. Or I could do this.
Please don't fall over. Hey everybody, how y'all doing? Name's Nero. I'm one of the dance family here. I'm from Raleigh, North Carolina. Anybody been North Carolina folk around here? Yeah, because the flights were terrible, so I understand there's not many of you here. I've been doing the dancing and judging for many, many years. It's an honor to be here to help you guys out again, and let's do this.
Hey guys, I'm Zeke. I'm a Yin. Okay, come on, I'm a Yin. Yeah, there we go. I thought Yins made more noise than that. I'm from Toronto, Canada, and you know, it's all cold up there, so I like it down here in Chicago where it's definitely not as cold. And I won last year, I think. So I'm gonna be judging as well with this panel and seeing who gets to take the crown this year and all that fun stuff. So hope you guys enjoy the show.
Hey, how's everybody doing? My name is Torrance T-Bucks Griffin and I'm from Chicago, Illinois. Hey, looking forward to having a great show. Put your hands together. When they come out here and give it their all, that's all I ask from y'all today. All right, let's get it going. Yeah.
Thank you, thank you. And thank you, AV, for getting that all situated. I'm gonna blame that on myself for not doing a sound check earlier. That was on me. All right, yeah. Ooh, I did bad. Yeah. All right, that's the one you get. You only get one. Yeah, that's better. I like that better. All right, anyways. Do you guys want to see some dancers? Yeah, you do. Oh. And we are gonna start this dance come off with a treat for you. How many people here like dogs? How many people here like sharks? How many people here like dinosaurs? This creature is some abomination of those things. And one time they killed Gale. And because of that, now they gotta go first. Because that's what happens when you mess with my girl. So on that note, give it up for the very well beloved, you know him, you love him, it's Ray!
Keep it up. I'm always loving what you're doing. Just thank you again for an amazing performance.
Thank you so much, man. That was amazing. That was so great. I appreciate you. Thank you for not telling me. I appreciate that. That's good, because otherwise this would have been a very... Hey! You go sit down. Jeez Louise. Hey. Go eat the audience. Oh, come on. Yeah, like there's not one of you that's like, okay. Jeez. I know my audience. Okay, all right. We started off with a bang. Oh my God. And it's just not gonna stop. It's never gonna stop. This dance comp is gonna be constantly fire. So, this next dancer, very near and dear to my heart, I love him very much. My first interaction with them was I was at Fernal Equinox up in Canada, great convention, you should go. And they were talking, and they turned around, they saw me, and they yelled and they screamed. And I said, wow, I must look particularly ugly today. That's good. But seriously, this dancer has inspired me so much. They only started dancing this year. They've taken off on TikTok, which is a thing the kids use. And they're like, I'm lip syncing to a song, but I'm in a fursuit, so you can't see my lips. But so this next dancer, I know there's gonna be a bunch of people in the audience that knows them, that loves them, I love them. Please give a round warm applause for the amazing Happy.
Time to get up there, like you had a little bit of interaction with, you know, both the music and people that were off stage as well. I thought that was really well played out, and you had a really, really strong performance overall. The one thing I want to point out is that a couple of the transitions between moves seemed like you were taking a little bit of time to like prepare yourself and, you know, just like get ready for like a deep breath and then barrel roll. And it's like, that's super, super awesome. But definitely you can level up your game by making those transitions a little bit smoother and just kind of like having cleaner transitions between moves for sure. And that's a disqualification. Yeah. We're done. All right. Happy. I think quit on life. User has left the channel.
EXE Dew has failed. Please restart.
Alright, Afi. You definitely killed that performance as well as the MC. So please continue to kill things backstage as long as we don't know about it. I want to see you keep on going. Alright, awesome job, Afi.
Happy. Watching you. Out here with your mange. No mange on my stage, will you? And now. Oh! Alright, anyways, hey, audience. Just to know that if you are standing in the back, you're probably still seats. And that if you are standing in the back, you are a fire hazard, so go away. Just a note. Just trying to make sure everybody is safe. So, next up, our next dancer. Oh, man. So, she came to prelims, and I was just like, oh, smitten. Very well executed. Oh my goodness. Judges, what do we have to say about picks?
very proud. The ballet style, the way that you executed your moves, the full extension is absolutely wonderful. You used the full amount of your stage. You were confident in your movements. It was a beautiful, beautiful piece. Just keep up exactly what you're doing. Try to work on your spins a little bit. I saw one of them, you kind of had a little bit of a wobble. Hey, that happens to all of us. But outside of that, it was magnificent. Thank you again.
Thank you so much, Pigs. That was amazing. Oh, it's so elegant.
We love you, Pigs.
I love you.
Snickers back there cushioned it. It's all good. All right. That had a lot packed into it for sure. And I love the fact that you actually switched up the tempo halfway through. You know, you went from, you know, that really sassy in your face, you know, attitude to something a little bit more robotic, a little bit more controlled. Yeah, and you started exploring, you know, a couple different styles that I haven't seen from you before, at least not in the dance comp. That being said, with those different styles, you know, there's obviously a bit of execution that could have been a bit better, you know, some of the waving, the back bend, and just overall, you know, those styles just require a lot of practice, and, you know, with that practice, it'll become sharper, it'll be cleaner, and especially in fursuit, it'll become more dynamic. So, you know, definitely I want to see a lot more power when it comes to, you know, some of those hits, some of those tuts, you know, make sure that you got those angles, you know, at those, you know, optimal angles, whatever they are, and, you know, overall it's going to make that performance so much stronger. Awesome job, though, Charlie.
Thank you, Charlie. That was fantastic. Thank you, thank you. Oh, I didn't even notice until right now that your harness is so rainbowy. I love that. Hell yeah, yay! Woo! I'm not, though. You know, I like ladies. They're straight. Very single. How are you? All right, my bros. Listen. You remember how I said we got groups?
Yeah.
Two people remember. Cool. All right, so, this group you got coming out here, you know them. You've seen them at dance competitions for a long time. That's for sure. And, you know, I love them deep down inside, but I'm a Boston dog, so I'm slightly offended by their choice in jersey right now, because I really don't like the Pittsburgh Penguins, but that's okay. So let's give it up for some AnthroCon hometown heroes. Let's give it up for the very well-loved, beautiful Atsu and Arrow. I thought you guys were gonna just transform into one giant robot. That was nuts. Oh my god, judges, how do we feel about that performance?
Aaron, how many times have you been on stage so far? Is it like two or three? Two? This is your second time on stage. You look professional. I know. And the crowd can sit here and understand. Atu is an amazing dancer. He's always improved and always shown what he has. To have you out here, I know you were nervous when we were backstage. I saw it, and you've always been that way, which is adorable as hell. But to tag team and see such a beautiful story, a love story between you two, and come into it and show it in movement, motion, you grow in just two times. You've grown exponentially. You belong on that stage with the rest of us, just like the rest of the fans. This team, ladies and gentlemen of MFF, this is a team right here. Thank you for not only making us all have diabetes from all the freaking sweetness that just came from that, but showing us what it means to have a true love and passion for not only each other, but the dance itself. Because you came into this for him, and you've done it. Thank you, guys.
I just wanted to say, like, that little smoochie at, like, the middle part of that, like, I'm sorry, can you guys just kiss again? Like, that was so adorable.
Aww.
Hey, y'all cute. Y'all cute. I think that you guys are great, but I don't respect your team choice.
You're just jealous.
It's because they know how to win.
Go Blackhawks!
Yeah! Look at you starting. Dude, look at
you starting. Okay, Moscow. Okay. Jeez. I can pick that voice out of a crowd in a second. Oh my lord. Okay, so it was sports jokes aside, the Patriots are best Tom Brady. Alright, so Alright, so let's get back to the cute dancers and distract it away from my sports talk. Alright. Yeah, sports ball. Woo! You know what? Dance, honestly, is its own sport. It's incredibly, requires elite amounts of athleticism and really fit bodies. Very fit. Yeah, so that's why I'm not dancing, and these people are. So, with that, this next dancer, you've seen him before, you definitely have. You love him, I love him. They've been at a few cons now. Now, it's the exact same dancer that you know, but a little bit different. So please welcome to the stage my good friend, Kay, but a little bit more gay.
Thank you.
girl. Look at your tail. It's like Skittles. Or 90% of the convention. Hell yeah! Hell yeah! All right, judges, what do we think about Kay?
I mean, Kay, I know that I've been watching you since your first dance competition, and I've been giving you feedback ever since your first dance competition, but the number one thing that you've impressed me with time and time again is the increasing amount of confidence that you have in your moves. You can tell when a dancer is confident in what they're doing. You know, they're not just doing a move and kind of just being like, and that's it. You know, you're actually throwing yourself out there. Every step that you take has a purpose, and you're owning that stage. And I think that's a huge, huge distinction between someone that's dancing and someone that's performing. So you've definitely improved in that aspect, and I love seeing you on that stage. And you know, obviously you're bringing the style out as well. You've got the vest, like Gail mentioned. You've even got the new tail as well. That looks like a really delicious popsicle I want right now. Just for the popsicle, not for, never mind. Anyhow. I love you, Humphrey. Anyhow, your confidence just keeps on going up and up, and I love to see that. And if you pair that confidence with just more variety in your steps and just, you know, some more refined movements, I think that you're going to be one of the greats in the next generation of dancers, Kate. So keep it up. Keep it up for sure.
He's great. Oh man, oh man, oh man! We are cruising on through this dance comp list! Oh, but what we have next is so very different from what we have seen so far. There's a small sector of people right there. You probably know what I'm talking about because I was having some apple juice last night. And raving about them. Yeah, I love juice. Yeah. So, who here, I gotta get real close to the edge of the stage because I'm blinded by the light. Who here likes horror movies? How about like horror in general and spooky stuff? Who likes spooky stuff? Yeah, me too, me too. All right, so. When I leave the stage and they come on the stage, I hope and pray for your souls. Because I think everyone's gonna die. Because that's how I felt yesterday. For sure. Please give it up for a brand new dancer. Give it up for Vesna!
You are now ready to the stage.
Can I chew on you?
Get
one chew.
Dude, that's not something you should be asking right now. Bad dude. Vesna, I absolutely love that track. I love seeing a little bit of a difference in the different styles that come out and present themselves to not only us, but the rest of the fandom. Your control was very, very well done. You have a lot of passion in all of your movements, and you look like you're hyperventilating, so it's okay. Just two little critiques that we were talking about is your flow. Your flow looks like one constant movement. So if we could try to see, maybe just break that up, it would accent your movements a little bit more and actually show more progression in your dancing, which is, it's not bad, but it's just something to help you rise to that level above what you're at right now. The only other, and the one other thing we looked at was your timing. Just make sure you listen to the music, make sure you hit those beats. You were doing it at some points were kind of a little off, but overall, an outstanding performance, and welcome. You deserve this. Good job.
Thank you, Vesna. That was amazing. Please don't kill all the other dancers. Thank you. They are a poltergeist, so I don't trust that they will listen to that. They are still baby audience member. Yes, they are. That is correct. Oh boy, howdy. Can't believe they didn't let me chew on the bone.
Yeah.
They were made of bones, Mac! Okay. Who here was at Flow Wars last night? Let me see. Yeah. Did you guys like Flow Wars last night? Right. Did you guys see that there was this one person that kept spinning? Yeah. And then they would do this thing with their body where it looks like every part of them should break at the same time, but it didn't. Yeah. I don't know how people do that. Especially birds, because the bones are hollow. They do it somehow, it's something crazy. Also, I'm pretty sure this person is the only person still buying windbreakers at this day and age and didn't stop in the 90s. So, let's give a big, 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 big round of applause for B-Boy Flitch!
You wings.
As I come back,
contact. You're probably wondering how I ended up in this situation.
Now this is a story all about how my life got flipped on upside down.
Give it up for B-Boy Flitch! win the windbreaker business in business. This proves my point. All right, judges, what do we think of Flitch and Flitch?
Is it like Flitch and his son, or like Flitch like had a really bad cloning session at like the chicken factory and like, it's okay, that's why I'm sitting down here, so you can't kick me. It's all good. Alright, Flitch. From one b-boy to another, I'm always happy to see the b-boys represent. B-boying is such a lost art form, but also one of the most important in my opinion. And it's glad, I'm super glad to see that it's still alive and well in furry fan culture. And you always bring out the best in b-boying. And you always try to innovate. You know, you try to get this crowd hype with all the stuff that you do. Like, crowd, if you can't do even a tenth of what he just did up there, make some noise. That is not something that you learn overnight. You have to practice for years and years and years on end to even do half of the stuff that he just did up there, I'll tell you right now. And, you know, the number one thing about b-boys is that, you know, we're known for those dynamics, but another big part of it is we're also known for the dance part as well. And that's one thing I want to leave you with today, is that there was an element of the b-boy dance that was a little bit lacking, which was the top rock part and a little bit of the grooving. So I would definitely want to see a little bit more of that, especially since you're representing the b-boy style in future performances. So, you know, you had amazing musicality, you had great execution, but, you know, tune up that dance part a little bit and it's all going to bring it together. All right, keep on going, Flint, represent.
Thank you, B-Boy! B-Boy, please! Oh, don't die, I appreciate you too much. You're both so great. Please don't die. Oh, you just kick him off. Yep. Wow, friendship. Still don't know what I just saw. I don't know how there's two of them. Okay, all right. Now, before we get to this next dancer, I want to thank someone. This someone is an entity. They make the lights, the sound, all of the fanciness. They make this stick with the thing on at work so I can talk to you. It's great. They understand technology where I don't. Let's give a huge thank you to Amy! People taking pictures and videos. Give it up for our photographers and videographers of the fandom. Yeah. That way, when you're too old or out of it, they help you remember. All right. Crowd, are you ready for another dancer that I know you know because they have been dancing? Well, a long time now, they've done a lot of dance competitions. And they're another dancer. It's the same, but looking a little bit different these days. So I would like you to give a very warm welcome to the epic Ombre!
I'm doing no sex.
You just got that suit, didn't you? It's brand new. It looks great. That's awesome. I love it. I love it. A nice refresh. All right, judges, what do we think about Ombre?
What's good, Ombre? Brand new you, brand new show. There's some parts in there that I have never seen from you before. I wasn't ready for that performance at all. Your dive stop rotation that you did is brand new, and that what we were just talking about, that was on point. That was probably one of the cleanest performances I have, in the time that we've known each other, that is probably one of the cleanest performances I've ever seen you do. Your control, I know I say control a lot, but control makes a show. When you sit there and you can stop and you know your time stops, your moments, your use of your knowing your body and your limitations, this is a brand new you, and I cannot wait to see what else you have in the future. Just keep it up and just, I'm amazed. You did amazing. Great job.
Only ever said at a furry convention. Yo, friendship. That's good. That's good. Okay. That's the old you. Don't be doing that. You can't just throw that thing. Don't throw it. I'm taking this away from you. It's mine now. That's right, go away. Okay, you can have it. Okay, now go away. Get out of here. Get out of here. Give it up for Ombre! Yes. Oh, man. Woo! Boy. Oh! That for me? Cool, thanks. I like chairs. Yeah. Nice. Yeah. How you doing? Doing pretty good. Hey, this actually kind of works. You know, Gail's not here right now, but if she was, you know, she helps run all this stuff. And she's not doing that next year. Yeah. You are. I want to give it up for Zephyr, who will be taking over for dance events here at MFF next year. Seats. Cool.
Yeah, chair.
Yeah, go chair. All right, judges, what do we think about chair?
Right to the floor.
Yeah. Hey, yo, chair, I really like how you're making use of the floor. Look at all that energy. It's got, look at those angles. Look at all those angles. Yeah, perfect. You got any great angles on that chair? Oh, so original. I love it.
All right, well, don't worry, guys. The chairs are out here for a reason. Quick poll of the audience. Who likes jazz music?
Yeah!
Y'all wanna go to the club? Y'all wanna go to a jazz club with me?
Yeah!
All
for my next number, I'd like to return to the classic.
Excellent job representing that with not only the music choices, but you know, the attire as well. Like, y'all are some fly looking gents up there. So that's what's up for sure. I will say that in terms of the performance itself, there were a couple of spots where it didn't really seem like you guys were synced up entirely, whether it was the timing or even a couple of the steps. And it just, you know, it just might be a difference in the styles. Knowing each of you individually, it might just be trying to bring the styles a little bit closer together, but also maybe just a little bit less, you know, dynamics going on. Like, dynamics are good, but sometimes if you keep it simple, especially as a team, it helps to keep you guys in line, you know, go on the same page, on the same beat. So other than that, you know, you guys got the style, you got the groove. All you need is the timing to make it work all together. But again, you guys brought that, you brought that flavor back, and I really appreciate y'all for it. Guys, give up one more time for the Roaring Ace Band.
Thank you guys so much. Thank you. Your chairs and things are backstage. Thank you, thank you. That was awesome.
See you, Space Cowboy.
Yeah!
That's right. See you, Space Cowboy. I like that. I like that. Okay, all right. Another quick poll. Audience poll. I like polling the audience. Who here, and it's probably not going to be many people, who here likes werewolves? I see you. I see you liking werewolves. I see you right there. All right. Yeah. You know what? You know what? Why the hell not? Let's do a howl. Is their first fursuit dance competition. Fursuit dance competition. And, you know, they are so cool that this guy, he gets into MFF. He gets into the biggest freak-on in the world. He gets into that dance competition. So I want you guys to give a warm round of applause for
do you
Okay, I see the performance will have more energy than you, but that's good. It's good. I just want to say, this next dancer, I literally live for their performances. I probably account for half of the views on each time Barton uploads a video of them. Because I just keep watching it and watching it and watching it. Because it is mesmerizing to me. I would love you guys to give lots and lots of energy to this performer because they're going to give it all back to you tenfold. Give it up for Seth Gladiator.
Great control of the music. You know, your movements match the music. The only thing that I did see was because of the stage, there were a couple of moments where there's a bit of shakiness and, you know, you're doing a few slip and slides, but you are also experienced enough that you didn't let that throw you off, which is super important because when you're on that stage, nothing is guaranteed to go right, you know, or perfectly, and you recovered, and that's super important. So that shows that you've got, you know, a lot of time in the game, that you've been practicing, and I just want to see you keep on going at it. Oh, suddenly, Bimani up here.
Hi, Bimani here. So, you just perfect full combo that performance. Triple A, you are the Dance Dance Revolution King right here.
Hey, Bimani. Y'all nerds.
Today.
yet we still haven't heard a complaint from Mr. Strings. Mr. Muscles didn't give us a complaint yet.
I mean, like, bro, it's just like bros. I just gotta show my love for my bro, you know? Sometimes bros gotta be bros. I'm still waiting for the AV to do like the but I'm
you done?
I mean, I could dab if you wanted.
Don't do that. Do not. Do not. That was the power of me. We do not do that here.
Yes, we do.
Okay, back to business. Let's not make fun of Duchef Hour. Jeez. Anyway, we're more than halfway through. That's crazy. I just realized the number. Oh my goodness, this next dancer. This next dancer, you've seen him before in different forms. Different forms. They're coming out in a brand new critter. But this next dancer has something very special we want to talk about. That's why I have a little note. This next dancer is dedicating their dance. They are dedicating their dance to their significant other, Carmen, because it is today their 2-year anniversary. So, please, 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 give a warm round of applause for Nico!
I would like to have seen you dance more musicality, but
you told a great story, and it looked like you had fun. And like I said, that's one of the most important things, okay? But next time, just work more on your dance element, because I just see enough of that.
Here and then that I'm gonna go off on that point about storytelling. Like, dance is telling the story of life through your movements. And I don't think that we've seen storytelling yet that was as, not only as precise and controlled as that, with so many different variations, so many different elements in it, but also, you know, actually incorporating different stories within that song. You know, you had parts where you were running with the song, with the actual person in the song. You had parts where you were stuck and you hit that little like hangman pose, absolutely perfect. Exactly, and it's just amazing seeing you being able to really bring out that song to life through your movements. And that's like expert level stuff. And that's something that I think is really, really rare to see, not only just in dance competitions at furry cons, but just dancing period. So extra, extra round of applause for Jamix for being able to do that anyway.
Closer to the finish line here. This next dancer. Oh man. First time I saw them, they knew her. Not new. First time I saw them though, I was like, what's this dragon about to come out here and do? And then they did it, and I was like, what the heck? That's smooth. Ooh. Skips and shivers. I love it. Love it. This guy, his name alone just tells you what he's about, tells you what he's like. And he's gonna come out here and he's gonna deliver a performance that's gonna boggle your minds. You're gonna feel real good afterwards. Give it up for my boy, Dapper.
Very, very smooth, very dramatic, and I I think we had to raise the PG rating because of that song as well. So yeah, I really appreciate that. Your movements were deliberate. You had a lot of sass when it came to it. You knew what you had and you worked it. That's amazing. So I just want to say thank you for that and just keep up the good work. Awesome job.
Thank you, guys. That was phenomenal. Thank you, thank you. Oh, my goodness. So, guys, I want to hold a little service real quick. Could you all please pray for the floor with me? It's going to be okay, floor. I'm very sorry about what's about to happen to you. I'm very, very sorry. If you are not here afterwards, you served us very well, and I liked dancing on you at the raves. Thank you for supporting me. I always want to support you. I love you, Floor.
I love you too.
Oh. Can we cuddle?
Yes.
Oh, yay. Finally, I get snuggles and scones with the Floor.
That's not how Floor Wars works, Gail. I do.
Jeez. All right, guys. We blessed the floor. It's about to get annihilated. Please, please, please put your hands together for the death and destruction of this entire stage. Give it up for Darkie!
Tell you, man, is just keep at was so good. I enjoyed it. John, enjoy it.
Great job. Oh, man. Wow. Happy you're still with us, buddy. Okay. Well, audience, I'm going to poll you again. One of my favorite things to do. Hey, when you guys were coming up with your personas, your characters, you ever have trouble coming up with a name? You ever no, not really. Okay, well, that one person that's very confident and wonderful, good for you. Good for you, that's great. I wish we all had that talent. I'm called Dusha because I'm Dew Colors. So that's how creative we got there. I do appreciate, though, when somebody's like a dog and their name's Bear. I like that. That's always good. So as we're talking about, you know, it's hard sometimes to come up with a name. I think these guys just gave up. I think they gave up. I don't... Maybe they were trying. Maybe they were like, oh, it's a working title. Just went with it. Went with it. But I'll tell you right now, they're going to come out here and you're going to know just who they are. So don't worry about that. But please, audience, give a big, big, big round of applause for Untitled Dance Crew Team! Okay, go up there and kill, give it up again, audience!
Another display, just like we had seen in a previous team, another display of the passion that exists between you two. Like, that is something that showed very clearly through the music, you know, that selection of that particular song, through the kind of interactions that you had each other with the stage. And that is a very excited goose back there. Yeah, and you know, the way that you guys played with your strengths, because you have so much that you threw in there, from the gymnastics, the acrobatics, to, you know, having the dance together, and, you know, having just a massive variety of different styles, because you two are so versatile with the way that you dance, and I really, really love it. The only thing being that you could tighten up a couple of those spots, you know, again, with being in its duo and, you know, doing it in fursuit, it's so much more difficult to really see the timing and see where your partner's at, and you gotta have that faith in each other, but all it needs is a little bit of tightening, and I think that it'll just be absolutely picture perfect. But you guys did amazing as well. Amazing job, guys.
Give me up for Let's Play Us Pieces, a very good piece. Untied up goose game, if you don't play it, you should. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Oh, man! All right. Next dancer. Oh. We're gonna pray for the floor again. Oh, Lord Almighty. Boy.
You got this floor?
Yeah, that's right, you got this floor. Okay. So, if you were at Floor Boys last night, you saw them actually on the judges panel last night. Yeah. You know who I'm talking about. They got that bunny aesthetic. They got that ram aesthetic. They got that elephant aesthetic. They got that booty for days. I want a warm, warm welcome to the beautiful, the wonderful, rambunctious. Very good. all rambunctious.
I don't have many words to say because every time you come out on the stage, it's a performance that I've just jaw dropped on every single time. Isolation, movements, energy, it's just, it's above reproach every single time. And you're adorable as hell, yes. But literally, I have no critique. That was absolutely wonderful. Thank you so much. Did you just get a tap? Use your words.
Bro, it's okay to express your feelings, bro.
Yo, he just... They just... With the... Maybe that means I love you in Ram Bunny. I don't know. What are you doing getting sneak peeks out here? You're ruining my joke. I had a whole joke lined up. You peeked out here.
I didn't see anything.
Great, good. Hey, audience. Hey, audience, I want to give you another poll. Can you guess what my favorite color is? I'll give you a hint. I have three favorite colors. Great job. Tablecloth. Great job. Wow. There he is.
You know he loved you, right, dude?
That was one of the only jokes I worked on before this.
It was great. I forgot to laugh. We still love you, dude.
Audience, give it up for Red!
I'm looking outside my window. I try to see where moonlight goes. I just don't know how it's lit up. There must be some kind of cloud. Every person could be you, though. I'm pretty guy with a halo.
So, that being said, I love you too, dude. Alright, that being said, I really, really enjoyed the playfulness, first of all, that you had with your choreography there, and you had a lot that you demonstrated in terms of style, where you actually incorporated a couple of elements from the b-boying that I saw, something that I had not seen from you before, and you actually were able to land quite a few of those as well. You know, one of the things that's dangerous about, you know, exploring new styles, especially on stage in a big competition, is you might not be familiar with how it feels, and that brings, you know, more risk in terms of whether you do it cleanly or not. But you actually did pull it off, and that's really, really impressive. One thing that I do want to say for sure is the transitions could use a little bit more energy, you know, just to match the rest of the moves, because you got energy with the individual moves, and if you stuck all those individual moves, now you got to bring it all together with energetic transitions as well. But other than that, you had a solid performance, and everything was put together really, really cleanly. Awesome job.
Thank you so much, man. That was awesome. He's a little rule breaker. Ruined my coloring joke. Guys, I hate to break it to you. We only got like 3 dancers left, I think. I know. But hasn't this been a great dance comp so far? Yes. This next dancer, another dancer you've seen many, many times. A dancer that if you were here last night, you saw at Flow Awards. Yeah. In fact, they were on the winning team. Yeah. How many of you guys like puppies? Like puppies. Yeah, I like puppies too. This puppy is very near and dear. Somehow this puppy is Gail's kid, which is weird because Gail's a cat, but we don't ask questions here in the band. Please put your hands together for the ever lovable AOE! Judges, what do we think about AOE?
All right. That was was a beautiful performance. I really enjoyed it. And one of the things that you did is like, you told a story. One of the things about dancing in general, dancing is the art of making the music visible. And that's what you did with that performance. So I really enjoyed it. There was no mistakes for me, man. I was all into that. So, and I'm sure the crowd dug it too. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you so much again, Amy. That was wonderful. Thank you. Oh crowd, we got two dancers left. Don't worry. They're still dancing after that. Don't worry.
Dance for us, dude!
No. Ha! No.
That's my line.
I know it's your line. Anyways. Next dancer really doesn't need an introduction. And I've introduced him before, so I've told the jokes. Who here likes dads? Who here likes butts? You do? Wow. That's so cool. Just you. Only you. Wow. Just you. Two. Two whole people like butts. Wow. Cool. Yeah. How about dad butt? Yeah. I would like to present to the floor my good friend, my bro forever, the guy that I live with. Give it up for Strokes!
All right. Strobes, you brought a lot of different elements together, and you did it very, very good. Now see why they call you Strobes. The waves were good, the isos were good. Did I see some tuts up there? Did you get a tut? Hit one for me right quick, give me a tut. Just one. I love that. Hey, all in all, that was a great performance. You made use of the stage. I got your story, and I felt it. All right? Thank you. Yeah.
Thank you, folks. Thank you. I think you get to keep the hat. That's your hat now. That's a hat. Yeah. Oh, I don't want it. It's pink. Just learned what the word was. Wait. Guys, we're on to our last dancer. But last dancer. Woo! I know, no bias, no bias, no bias. Everybody's got their favorite animal. Some people think that tigers are the best. Some people think angel dragons are the best. Some people think that house cats are the best. All of them have opinions, and they are all wrong. Because the best animal in the world is a German Shepherd. German Shepherd. So please give a round of applause for Macro.
Thank you.
Nice job, dude. Nice job. Holding it down with a cheek duck, fam. Hell yeah. All right, judges, what do we think about Rhapsody?
Rhapsody, bringing in the rap, bringing in the sass, bringing it all together with so much attention to detail. I'm going to tell you right up, like, the attention to detail they had for all those different songs and all the different elements of those songs, from the lyrics to the bass line to all the different, you know, kicks and snares in the background, you know, a lot of it, it's easy to miss. You blink and you'll miss it, but, you know, your performance, you not only hit those, but you made it visible as well. And like T-Bug said, it's important to make those elements visible when you're hitting those specific parts of the song. So you did a phenomenal job of doing that across all of your songs. And I just want to say, like, you are such a pleasure to watch every time you come up on the stage. So keep at it. And one more time, crowd, for Rhapsody. Give it up. Give it up.
Thank you so much, dude. That was phenomenal. Oh, gosh. How about that for a dance comp audience? How about that? Yeah. But you know, the judges, they're going to need some time to deliberate. I was doing some thinking, which is hard for me, but I did it for you, so I appreciate you. And MFF has been around for 20 years. That means the first MFF is MFF 2000. So I went back and I was like, huh, I wonder what the top music in 2000 was. Well, with that knowledge, I want to bring my dancers back out on the floor, please. Dancers, come on out. Come on out. Come on out as you can. Audience, let's give it up again for all of our dancers. Give it up, give it up, give it up. Yeah. I want them to come out here. And as they're coming on out, hey, AB, I had that song I told you about. If you could do me a good solid right now and play that song, I'd appreciate that. Don't worry, you guys will see the other dancers soon.
Daddy.
Zephyr, Kobe, we have backstage. We had all of our prelims judges with Zephyr and Remix and Tej. I appreciate you all so much. Also, a very special thank you to T-Books for coming up.